1992, at the University of Lagos, Sowore led 2,000 students in protest against Nigeria's notorious kleptocracy. Police opened fire, killing 7. Sowore was arrested, interrogated, and beaten, and later found out his family too had been put under pressure. But he refused to back down in the struggle for decent education in his country, and was soon elected executive president of the University Student Union. Since then, he has continued to fight for human rights. He's been imprisoned 8 times and tortured, but he remains committed to fighting against the multinationals that have only benefited the select few running Nigeria. He's adamant he will one day return to Nigeria. As he says, change will not come to Nigeria on a platter of gold. If you want justice, you have to fight for it. So now, without further ado, Mr. Omoyele Sowore.
Thank you and good evening. And I want to thank you guys for coming in spite of your over-programmed lives on the campuses. We are here to discuss something that I think is very important. Not only important to me or to the people of Nigeria, but it's important to all of us because oil has become a very slippery part of our humanity. And what I'm going to try to do in the next 30 minutes or 45 minutes is to give you an idea of where I come from and the role of oil in that part of the world where I come from. I was just having a conversation with a professor here, and it's something I'd always talked about. It's to define Africa in the simplest possible way, simplest way possible for students in the U.S. is to let you understand that Africa is this large swath of land that was partitioned by merchants to such an extent that most African nations were named after resources. It was the most audacious thing that anybody can do. So you can look at Africa as a huge supermarket where you have aisles and aisles of, they'll say, shaving needs, you know, baby products, you know. In the case of Nigeria, where I come from, it used to be slave courts. And then Cameroon is actually named after shrimps. There used to be ivory coast where there's ivory. There's a place called Gambia, actually, that somebody told me was supposed to be game by us. And then somebody converted it to Gambia because people just go there and shoot animals. So that gives you an idea of the continent of Africa. But I'll break it down further to Nigeria, where I come from. Nigeria, having changed from, you know, a slave coast to Nigeria, is still another very lazy way of dealing with that problem, because a certain Lord Lugard came to Nigeria who had a girlfriend named Flora. And when they were looking for what to name Nigeria, I guess after it wasn't fashionable to call it slave coast anymore, the lady, after getting drunk one night, said that why don't you just call it Niger area, because it was where the river Niger, you know, entered into the Atlantic Ocean in form of tributaries and a lot of water bodies. And where I come from is the Ondo, the southern part of Ondo State, where the Niger Delta region is. The Niger Delta region, of course, is made up of lakes, rivers, streams, and all kinds of water bodies, swamps. And it's very rich, first, I would say, in alluvial soil, you know, which makes it very, very arable. And later, it was such that after slavery went into extinction, you know, I don't know whether to say it has or not, the next thing that was marketable in that region was palm oil. You know, and it was because it was a very, very agrarian society and people were growing a lot of palm trees, and palm oil was the next thing that attracted the merchants to the Niger Delta region. And when palm oil went out of vogue, came oil. So in 1959, the first oil deposit was discovered in a place called Oluebiri near Port Harcourt in Nigeria River, Niger Delta region. And since 1959, there has been a constant, unceasing, and relentless drilling of oil in Nigeria. And you can also say a constant and inhumane killing of the people of the Niger Delta region. I will explain very soon. Between 1959 and today, they have pumped out some $500 billion worth of oil from the Niger Delta region. And if all of you at least watch TV and, you know, read the internet, you notice that oil has now gone to $100 per barrel. So part of it comes from Nigeria.